Hi, my name is Brian, and today I'm going to show you how to integrate LaunchDarkly within a Next.js application that has statically generated pages. We're going to look both at how to actually integrate the SDK so that we can get flagged values within our project, but also we're going to look at how you can cause those pages to regenerate. Keep in mind, these are statically generated assets, so we'll need to actually rebuild them in order to see some of those changes, and we'll see how that can be done. So let's get started. So let's start with which SDK you should use. Now, Next.js, as you know, uses React, so you might be inclined to use the React SDK, but the thing is, that is a client-side SDK, and the processing for static site generation is done on the server or locally on your machine or your build server or whatever server, but it is not done on the client. So you need a server-side SDK, you need the Node.js SDK. You can find instructions for installing it in the LaunchDarkly docs. You can just install it via NPM, and it's available for you to use. We'll assume you've already installed it, and let me show you how to use it. I've created an example project that includes a number of different rendering options within Next.js. Obviously, in this video, we're concerned with the static rendering. There are two pages that use static rendering here. This home page, which lists out a bunch of blog posts that are pulled from the Dev API. If you're not familiar with Dev, it is a site that features a ton of articles for developers, and we're pulling articles that are under my username at the moment. I'll show you how we're going to flip that using a flag. The other page we have is an About Us that's just pulling content from a static markdown file and rendering it. We are going to change which markdown file it renders using a flag, and we'll look at how to do that as well. So now that we've got the sample project, let's take a look at the flags that we're using. So let's look at the flags we have for this example. I have two flags in my flag dashboard here that are relevant to the statically generated pages. The first one is this featured username. The featured username controls which username is displayed on that homepage. So as you recall, right now it's my username, but if I flip this switch on, it will actually change. And I reload the page, it will change to Ali Spittel's content. So let's look at how that works here in the flag. So we have two variations. One variation, this is a string flag. One variation is remote synth, that's my username. And the other is Ace Patel, that's Ali's username. So when I flip that switch, it switches which username is used to actually build that page. I do have to refresh though, because that is a statically generated page running on my local server. So let's look at the other one. The other one is this new About Us flag. This flag, I have, again, two string variations. One is about and one is about-new. This actually tells Next.js which page to load. So as you can see on the About Us currently, it says this is the old branding page. And if I click and change this, let's go here. And I'm going to flip on new About Us. Let's save those changes. And I go, and again, this is statically generated, so I do need to reload. You'll see that this says, this is our new About Us page featuring new branding and more flowery marketing language. And yes, my spelling is imperfect. So let's see how that works within the Next.js code. So let's look at the code that makes this work. I've created a little library here to initialize the SDK, because that's the first thing we need to do before we can use it. The reason I created this library is because this application has all types of rendering, not just statically generated pages, but also has server-side rendered pages and pages that use incremental static regeneration, or ISR, which is a feature of Next.js. So the first thing I need to do is import the LaunchDarkly Node SDK. And then I have these two methods, getClient. What it does is simply, if the client's already been initialized, it'll pass that back. If not, it will initialize it. Obviously, the initialize function initializes the SDK, passing my SDK key, which is on my accounts page within my dashboard. And I've stored that in an environment variable in a .env.local file. I wait for that initialization and then pass that back. Pretty simple. And then I can reuse that throughout my application. So I import it on any page that needs to get flags. And then I get the client. And then once I have the client, I can get the variation, the variation being the value of the flag, depending on whether that flag is active or not. So in this case, I'm calling the featured username flag. and I'm passing an anonymous user, because this is statically generated, I can't pass user details. I don't have them when this generates within the build. LaunchDarkly allows you to do really interesting things to target users or groups of users based on user data that you pass. But unfortunately, when you're statically generating pages, you can't do that because the page is being pre-rendered before it ever hits the user. So you don't have user information. So in these cases, I have to pass an anonymous user. Once I get the featured username, I can use it within the API here that determines what data it's going to get, and that's how I populate the page. Now on the About Us page, similar thing, importing the library, getting the client. I actually have two flags going on here. We didn't discuss this when we looked at my dashboard, but there is a Show About Us. What the Show About Us is going to determine is whether the page even displays for a user. If we haven't turned on that page, it will actually 404. Not to get sidetracked too much here, the key one here that I want to discuss is this new About Us. That's the flag that determines which version of the content is loaded. So I get the value, again, passing an anonymous key, and then that determines which page I import. So it's either going to import the about.md from my content folder or about-new.md. Remember, those are the variations within my flag, and that determines what markdown I load before I render the page. So now that we've added this to the code, it all works locally on my local server. But what happens when I deploy it? When I initially deploy, it's going to get the value at the time of the deploy. So what happens if I change that flag after the deploy? What I needed to do is actually know that certain flags need to force a redeploy. So let's look at how to do that. So for this example, we're going to look at Netlify. Obviously, this works on other hosts like Vercel and Cloudflare. But in this case, we're looking at Netlify. Netlify has something called build hooks. So if you go to your site settings and you go to build and deploy and you scroll down here, you'll see build hooks. Now I can add a new build hook, and what that does is just give me an endpoint to call. And when that endpoint is called, it's gonna trigger a rebuild. And I can target that rebuild depending on which branch I want to build. In this case, I would want to build main, which is my production branch, but I've actually hooked up two here that do both the production and the testing branch. Because you can have a different environments within LaunchDarkly, you can actually create different build hooks that will target the build of that particular branch that you're working on. Let's just look right now at the production branch. So all I need from here is to copy this URL, and then I'm gonna jump into LaunchDarkly. So let's go into my LaunchDarkly dashboard. I'm gonna go to the integration section here. And what I want to do is actually add a webhook. So if you need to, you can search for webhooks here. I already have it up here. You would click add integration, but let's see how my integration works. So I have two integrations, Netlify production, Netlify staging, which are those test environments and the production environment. Let's look at production and examine how this works. So I can give it a name. I've given mine Netlify production. I can give it the URL, which is the endpoint that Netlify gave me. I copy and paste that here. I do not need a secret in this case. Now here's where things get a little bit interesting. I do need to click this advanced editor. The advanced editor will give me the option to supply some code that tells LaunchDarkly how to target this webhook. Let's examine that a little bit. I am targeting the default project, which is in my account. I only have one project, but you can get the project name under your account settings. And then the environment is production. So any changes to flags on the production environment would cause this build to be triggered. However, I don't want this to be triggered for every single flag. So I don't want a flag that may affect a client-side value to cause a new build on Netlify. So what I've done is I've actually created a tag. This tag is called build impact. So any flag that has the build impact tag will cause this rebuild. Let's see how that looks within my feature flags. As you can see here, some of these flags have this build impact tag, some of these flags do not. If I were to flip this header text flag, it is not going to trigger a rebuild. However, any one of these with the build impact tag will trigger a rebuild on Netlify. So I know I threw a lot at you here, and I don't expect you to just keep rewatching the video to get the details you need to implement this yourself. I've created a guide called Using LaunchDarkly with Next.js that goes into detail on everything I've covered here, as well as other rendering methods that you can use within Next.js and how to integrate LaunchDarkly there. In addition, I have written this blog post on Netlify, how to use LaunchDarkly feature flags with Netlify, that goes into how to hook the webhooks with the Netlify deploy hooks so that you can trigger the build on the environment you want to target. In addition, the guide goes into how to do this for Vercel if you are hosting your application there as well. Finally, you can go to my GitHub, and I have the code for this entire application is there on GitHub. So if you want to just pull the code so you can see how that works, you can do that as well. I hope this was helpful, and look for more content about how to use Next.js with LaunchDarkly in upcoming videos.